exact same. I get my leg outside, right? Just because I get my leg outside here doesn't mean this is over. As I start to kick down, start to jack this leg up, he can still do all these moves, right? So let's go ahead inside quickly. He still has finishes here, so I just want to point that out, right? Like, just because that guy gets the leg outside doesn't mean they're dead in the water. We're not going to practice that one today. So what we're going to do next is a series of how to survive if he actually does get over your leg, if he does get to step over on that, right? So we're starting the same. He takes the shot. And this time, maybe I lose the wizard and he steps over, right? And I'm pretty much dead here, especially if he's as high up on my leg as Alon is right now. This is perfect. Right? I'm in a lot of trouble. So the first thing I'm gonna do here, if he's really far up, you might get in a scenario where your wizard doesn't really feel like it helps you. And in fact, if you start to reach back first, he'll just go tip your head into me. Yes. Put me in my back, right? And that's just gonna be a feel thing that you're gonna have to learn, the trade-off between going for this wizard maybe first or going to the head first. I guess it's actually less about what comes first and what comes second, but where you place the emphasis, right? So I'm never just gonna not have a wizard. I'll go to the wizard, but maybe instead of really trying to recover this deep wizard that requires me to sit back, right? Instead, I just get a short wizard, I start to push his head away, and then I can work in, right? Once I'm here, once I've created this space, it's much harder for him to finish, even if my hips are sitting back a little bit. So once we're here, once the leg's inside, I'm sure you're asking yourself, okay, what do we do? Well, we're gonna go over two scenarios. The first is where this guy just screws up. A lot of people get here and they're like, I've got my opponent dead to rights, and they start to reach up to a seagull. Yes, this is exactly what I want, right? Whether he goes two hands or one hand, I don't really care. This is what I want, because from here, all I'm gonna do is use this wizard. I can even take my hand off the head, and I wanna wizard down hard, right? Once I wizard down, go ahead, stay stepped over it for now. Once I wizard down, now, I'm gonna limp leg out. We limp arm a lot in wrestling, right? Where we do this, we don't limp leg that much. Here's a great scenario where we can do it. The way I'm gonna do this is, once I've wizard down, I have all his weight over his head, I'm gonna slide this leg forward and out, right? Forward and out.
I'm covering.
Sorry, right inside, okay? Again, he stepped over, I don't know the best thing. Is this a good angle? Okay. He stepped over, I feel like I'm way out front, I can't just wizard, he's already stepped over, that's fine. I get a short wizard, I get on his head, he starts to work up, great. I lift leg out, right? I slide this leg forward, and now I switch that foot, just like before. Any questions on that one? Remember, this is what happens when this guy screws up. And there is actually a way to bait this that we should talk about quickly, which is just wrenching on this wizard, right? The way that I bait a lot of guys to let go of this leg is I get this deep wizard, and I just really lean forward. And I'm like, okay, great. You came up, that's fine. Even if he goes to the body lock, I'm okay here, right? Because I've timed it out, I've controlled the position, I can feel when he releases. What I don't want, go ahead and go back to that body lock, is to stay here and not limp leg, right? If I don't limp leg here, I'm done, take me back. Right? So I've gotta move, once I get to here, I've gotta move my hips out front before I can turn, okay?
Is it a hip movement or is it a leg movement? It feels like it's more like a hip movement.
It's a little bit of both. It's almost like a baseball slide scenario, right? So my leg is nice and tight here. I'm sort of loosening and then going this direction, right? I post it, I give it a little bit of slack here, I slide through. Yeah. Yep. And as I do it, my hips are switching, right? Slide, turn. Let's try it.